Hello everyone. In this video, I will present a joint work with Stéphanie Delaune and Mathieu Vavry about boomerang distinguishers. So, boomerang distinguishers were introduced by Wagner in 1999, and the main idea is to combine two short differentials, as it may lead to a better probability than using only one long differential. To compute the probability of the corresponding boomerang, we need some independence assumption. Unfortunately, this assumption does not hold in practice. Indeed, we found several examples of non-returning boomerangs, and the problems occurs at the junction of both the lower and the upper differentials. So some attempts were made to refine the probability of boomerangs. But in 2018, Sid et al. Introduced the Boomerang Connectivity Table, BCT, as a unified view of all the previous works in the domain. Basically, the BCT is only a pre-computation of all possible boomerangs through one single S-box, and the definition of the BCT is right here on the slide. So to search for the best boomerang characteristic, the original process was to first search for the best differential characteristic on R1 rounds, then search for the best characteristic on R2 rounds, and to combine them to get an optimal boomerang characteristic on R1 plus R2 rounds. Since we know we have to refine the complexity, the probability of the corresponding boomerang characteristic. Actually, the process did not change so much. We still search for the best differential characteristics on R1 and R2 rounds, and we combine them, but now we evaluate its probability in a more careful way. The problem is that this approach is not optimal anymore because it is not clear that optimal characteristics will lead to optimal boomerang characteristic. That's why we started this work, and actually our main idea was to search for boomerangs directly without searching for differential characteristics. So we propose a new three-step approach to search for the best boomerang distinguishers. So first, we propose a MILP model to search for truncated boomerang characteristics. Then we use a CP model, a constraint programming model, to search for the best instantiations of truncated boomerang characteristics. So if we combine the first and the second step, we obtain a process to search for the best boomerang characteristics. And then we have a third step in which we will precisely compute the probability of a boomerang distinguisher by computing a cluster of boomerang characteristics. So this work is dedicated to Skinny, to the block cipher Skinny, but it is highly adaptable to many other ciphers. So why Skinny? Well, Skinny is a very easy block cipher. In particular, the mixed column matrix is a binary matrix, which simplifies a lot the corresponding constraint for valid transitions through the mixed columns. The tweaky schedule is linear, which also simplifies a lot all the models. And both the DDT of the 4-bit S-box and of the 8-bit S-box do contain a lot of different values, which is very interesting for differential cryptanalysis techniques. So here are the results we obtained against the various versions of Skinny. So as you can see, we obtained a lot of new results, a lot of new boomerang distinguishers. And in particular, we improved all the previous works. And for instance, if you look at this particular line of this table, for 18 rounds of Skinny 128 in the TK2 setting, the probability of the best boomerang distinguisher we found is 2 to the minus 47, which is 2 to the 30 times better than the best than the probability of the best previously known boomerang distinguishers in this setting. So how did we got all those results? First, to compute, to search for the best boomerangs, we need to be able to precisely compute the probability of a boomerang characteristic. And to do that, the BCT is not enough. We need much more differential tables. So in particular, we need 3 extra tables. So the UBCT for upper BCT, the LBCT for lower BCT, and the EBCT for extended BCT. All those tables correspond to one particular case and depends on which differences are set to specific values and which differences are free. So both the UBCT and LBCT were already introduced in previous works. Sometimes they had different names. For instance, they are also called BDT and BDT prime. Regarding the EBCT, it is mostly new and it was only proposed as a future work by Minier et al. So once we have all those differential tables, it is actually quite easy to compute the probability of a particular boomerang characteristics. All we need to do that is to look at whether at which differences are set to specific values and which differences are free and which differences are set to zero. That's all. So for instance, for this particular S-box, regarding the upper trail, both the differences at the input and the output of the S-box are set to specific values. And for the lower trail, both differences are zero. So in that case, it corresponds to a DDT. And the probability of this transition is only the probability of the transition D to 2 through the S-box. But if we look, for instance, at this particular S-box, now, as before, so both differences at the input and the output of the S-box in the upper trail are set to specific values, but this time in the lower trail, the difference at the input of the S-box is also set to a specific value, and the difference at the output of the S-box is free. In that case, it corresponds to a UBCT, and so we look at the corresponding probability in the UBCT table. So what is very important here is that knowing which table will be used for the probability computation only depends on few parameters. First, we need to know whether differences are set to specific values or not, or if they are free. And If they are set to specific value, then we need to know whether this value is zero or if it's a non-zero value. And that's all what we need to know which table will be used in the computation of the probability. So this helps us to derive a new model to search for truncated boomerang characteristics, where basically we just use classical MILP model to search for truncated differential characteristics. We copy it twice, one for the upper trail and one for the lower trail, and we add extra variables. So for each S-box, we will add extra variables to know whether the difference is controlled or if it is free. And that's all. And then it's quite similar to a search of truncated differential characteristics. So obviously we added some specific constraints for those new variables, for those controlled variables. And we added also specific constraints to know in which table will be used in the computation of the probability. And while for the search of truncated characteristics, we count the number of active S-boxes, here it's quite the same, but instead of counting the number of active S-boxes, we will count how many DDT are involved, how many BCT are involved, how many EBCT are involved, and so on. And so we have something very similar. So the objective is just this number of different tables weighted by the maximum probability exponent of each of those tables. An important property of this MILP model is that we did not define any middle round, and actually both the lower and the upper trails are on the wall cipher, right? So there is no middle round. They are spread over all the cipher in theory. And to show that this model is very generic, we found that in some cases it automatically switches to the search of differential characteristics by setting, for instance, the lower trail to zero. So all difference are null in the lower trail. And in that case, it automatically switches to differential characteristics, to truncated differential characteristics. So that's our MILP model for to search for truncated boomerang characteristics. We can apply it to skinny. So we didn't apply it directly to skinny. Before we made some simplifications. So in particular, we found that for the DDT, the UBCT, the LBCT, and the EBCT, they all have the same probability of optimal transition. And so basically we just group them, all of them, into one table to simplify the corresponding constraints. We also use the Quinn-McCluskey algorithm to reduce the number of inequalities, and it helps us a bit. So as a result, we obtained this table. So how to read that? Actually, it's quite similar to the case of truncated differential characteristics. So basically here it's the number of tables involved in boomerangs. And for instance, this 40 here means that in the TK3 model, the best boomerang characteristic on 24 rounds has a probability at most equals to the minus 80. Okay. So it's very similar to the search of truncated differential characteristics. So now that we were able to compute truncated boomerang characteristics, we used a constraint programming model to find the best instantiations of them. So basically, this model is highly inspired by a works we made with Minier and Charles Prudhomme and Victor Molimar, which was published at ACNS 21. And actually, in this work, we found that a CP model was much faster than a MILP model to instantiate differential characteristics. This is because the DDT is highly non-linear, so using linear constraints to describe it is very complicated and leads to an inefficient model. While in constraint programming model, we can directly use what is called a constraint table, in which we can directly set all the possible tuples for for any operations. And so we used this model to instantiate many of the truncated boomerang characteristics we found during the first step. Since this model was very fast, was very efficient, what we did was to start clustering with this model. So first, we search for all optimal instantiations of truncated boomerangs, and then for each of them, we kept the input, the output, and the difference and the key, and we search for extra instantiations with the same input, output, and difference on the key. Of course, we added some time limits, and we also added some extra constraint on the probability of those new instantiations. So they should not be too far away from the optimal probabilities. But we start clustering using this CP model. And this allowed us to identify interesting boomerang distinguishers. And now, for each of them, we performed a very precise probability computation, so a very precise cluster analysis. So, given a boomerang characteristic, as in this example, we can erase all intermediate differences and just replace them with variables, okay? And compute the probability of the distinguisher as a sum of the probability of all the possible boomerang characteristics. Unfortunately, this sum is quite big, and we cannot compute it directly. So what we first did was to propose a new algorithm based on dynamic programming to reorder the formula in such a way so the depth of the formula is the lowest possible. So here you can see that to compute the formula, I will have to guess at most five variables each time. Okay, so five loops. Okay, unfortunately, this was not always enough to precisely compute the formula, and we had to perform some manual steps to approximate the formula. So, for instance, when we have some XOR like here, maybe we can replace it by a BCT, like say this is free, or sometime we will just force some value for intermediate differences. So we had to make approximations on the formula because on the formulas because it was not always possible to compute them exactly. But still, we obtained very good results as already mentioned it. So some of those boomerang distinguishers have a high enough probability, so we can try it in practice, and we did that. So we ran experiments to compare the actual probability of those boomerangs compared to what we predicted. And as you can see, for some of the boomerangs, it's quite close. But for some of them, it's a bit, it's not that close. Okay, here there is a difference of 2 to the 3, so 8. And we believe this is because in all our computations, we assume that both sides of the boomerangs follow the same differential characteristics, while in practice, they only have to follow the same differential. So this may explain the difference between the observed probability and the expected probability. So to conclude, in this work, we propose a new combined MILP-CP ad hoc approach to search for boomerang distinguishers, and we obtain many new results on the block cipher skinny. There are still open problems regarding this work. So first, our MILP model generates a lot of redundant solutions, meaning solutions that will lead to the exact same boomerang distinguisher. So the MILP problem model could be improved. I also told you that we only considered the case where the same differential characteristics is used on both sides of the boomerang, and we had to use some approximations to evaluate the probabilities. So all the source codes of all our different algorithms and models are available at this URL. And we also have all the experiments we made. There are also a PDF with all figures of all the boomerang distinguishers. And if you have any question, you can send me an email if you have some trouble to make it work. Okay, thank you for your attention.